just resting, waiting for a new life to come.
Attention.
God damn it, entire generation. Gas. Waiting tables. Slaves, white houses.
Advertising has to chase cars and clothes.
Working jobs we hate. Buy shit don't need. The middle children is history, man. No purpose, a place.
We have no great war. No great depression. Our great war is a spiritual war. Our great depression is our lives.
Always knows no tells me legally when one day we'll be millionaires and movie gods and rock stars.
The mind is a labyrinth, ladies and gentlemen, a puzzle. And while the paths of the brain are plainly visible, its ways deceptively apparent, its destinations are unknown, its secrets still secrets. And, if we are honest, it is the lure of the labyrinth that draws us to our chosen field, to unlock those secrets. Others have been here before us and have left us signs, but we, as explorers of the mind, must devote our lives and energies to going further, to tread the unexplored corridors in the hope of finding, ultimately, the final solution. We have to see. We have to know.
Dr. Chenard, the new arrival is awake and appears very distressed.
Is this me?
Who said that? Who the fuck said that? Who's the slimy little communist shit twinkle toe cocksucker down here who just signed his own death warrant? Nobody, huh? The very fucking godmother said I'm fucking standing. I will BT you all until you fucking die. I'll BT you until your asshole for sucking buttermilk. Was it you, you scroungy little fuck, huh?
Sir, no, sir.
You little piece of shit. You look like a fucking worm. I bet it was you.
Sir, no, sir.
Sir, I said it, sir.
Well, no shit. What have we got here? Fucking comedian, private joker. I admire your honesty. Hell, I like you. You can come over to my house and fuck my sister. You little scumbag! I got your name! I got your ass! You will not laugh! You will not cry! You will learn by the numbers! I will teach you! Now get up! Get on your feet! You had best unfuck yourself or I will unscrew your head and shit down your neck!
Sir, yes, sir!
Private Joker, why did you join my blood and gold?
Sir, to kill, sir!
So you're a killer?
Sir, yes, sir!
Let me see your war face!
Sir!
You got a war face? Ah! That's a war face! Now let me see your war face!
Ah!
Bullshit! You didn't convince me! Let me see your real war face!
Ah!
You don't scare me! Work on it!
Exactly! Go on, kiddo! Take it! Oh, you want it, don't you, Georgie? Oh, of course you do. And there's cotton candy and fries and all sorts of surprises down here. And balloons, too. All colors.
Do they float?
Oh, yes. They float, Georgie. They float. And when you're down here with me, you float down!
Now, I'll possess myself if I gotta... Wow! Yo, I got demons running all through me. Come on down here and see it. And hey, yeah, now, get a free demon possession with every exorcist. Nah, you can't beat that, can't you? Then bring a little parts down here. Hell, we got plenty of snakes and lizards, worms, and blue. No problem with that at all. quickly and twice. Third time's a charm. And remember, I leave this thing you up and eat. I swallow anything you up and swallow. Come on down now. Chew on it down.
What are your qualifications?
I didn't truly argue. I'm a graduate of the Harvard Business School. I've traveled quite extensively. I lived through the Black Plague, and I had a pretty good time during that.
I've seen The Exorcist about 167 times, and it keeps getting funnier every single time I see it. Not to mention the fact that you're talking to a dead guy. Now, what do you think?
You think I'm qualified?
What I mean by this, can you be scared?
Don't worry, Dave. All we want to do is kill you.